Hi, I'm Joycelyn Akufo. I'm the Managing Director of Gig School Tutoring. So at this time of year, we tend to get quite an influx of parents with children in year five who are considering the 11 plus exams, whether it's for the grammar schools or the independent schools. And many of them are surprised to hear, in particular for grammar schools, that the children actually sit the exams early year six. So for parents who live in my area of work, so that's Kent, Bexley, Medway, the Sutton County selection tests, the exams actually take place in year six, as expected, but they take place in September of year six. So effectively, after the year five summer holidays, children literally go back, and often the exams are in the first or second week, with the results coming out in October. So children don't have the benefit of year six to prepare for the test. They actually need to be ready by the end of year five, or at least by the end of August, in order to be in with any chance of success for these tests. And that tends to come as such a surprise, which is why I always recommend to parents to let their child start preparing at least in year four, because you don't have year six as part of that preparation. Independent school exams are quite interesting. Mostly, the exams take place in January of year six, so they're at least getting the autumn term, you know, through with before they sit the exam. But for many of the girls' schools, interestingly, they sit the exams in November, which means very soon after the independent school, sorry, the grammar school exams, they're in an exam hall again. Some boys' schools and co-educational mixed schools, they have a first phase exam in November, then invite the children who are successful back in January for another test. So it's something to bear in mind. In terms of applying for these exams, now is the time if your child is in year five. So for example, Bexley and Kent typically open their registration, which is online, in May or June. And they close around the end of July-ish. It changes sometimes for different boroughs. So it's really worth keeping an eye on the website of the local borough. A grammar school you want your child to go to is in order not to be disappointed. I've had parents who've contacted me in August thinking that their child will write their exams later on in year six, and that, you know, so how do I apply, where do I apply? But then in August, registrations have closed, and because there is such a high demand for these schools, and they're often inundated with registrations, they really won't listen to any case. Not knowing is not a good enough reason, unfortunately. So it's well worth putting a note in your diary, on a reminder on your phone, if you have a child who's in year three or year four, just to trigger. And it's a good idea also to maybe read some of these free newspapers for the local area in which the grammar school is in, just so that you can keep abreast of what's happening and when these exams open, to avoid disappointment. So thank you very much for watching, and there are lots of other videos on this channel. The aim is to help parents who want their children to secure a place in a grammar or independent school. So if there are any areas of concern that you'd like me to maybe look at talking about, or, you know, provide some information on, please either drop me a line, write something in the comments, and I'll do my best to try and help you. Thank you for watching.